Hey guys, we got a new series of quick series of hand-eye coordination drills for you. We've been getting some good feedback on the other two hand-eye coordination drills that we have on YouTube right now. You can check those out. For this sequence, each one kind of sort of builds on each other, so you can just try them in sequential order. The idea is just to get both sides of your body coordinating properly to improve your hand-eye coordination, your footwork a little bit, your natural organic footwork. Instead of doing set drills, you're doing a drill where the ball may not come back exactly where you intended, so you have to adjust but still keep the rhythm and keep the drill going. So try to do it smoothly and in a continuous rhythm. If you're looking for very specific training for more specific application into one sport or another, or refining your technique in any sport, that is something more for individualized training. You can apply below, but we'll keep trying to put out content like this that is for universal athletic development. You can warm up with just tapping your opposite shoulder and catching the ball in the same hand you throw it up with, so you can pass it over in between. And this is just basically getting like both sides of your body warmed up, both sides of your brain, so that you're thinking, so you can tap the knee, you can tap the hip. You're just trying to cross the body, okay? You can also throw it up, tap, and catch with the opposite hand. Tap the hip. Tap the knee. Okay, so you can just mix it up. Now you're gonna take that to the wall. So you can start off throwing and catching with the same hand and tapping the opposite shoulder with the same hand as well. So you're gonna throw with the right hand, tap the left shoulder, and catch with the right hand. Then you could do the same thing, but just tapping the knee. So you throw. When you're doing this, like the point is to always make sure that you're in a balanced and active position. So the point is not just to throw it, tap your knee, and then try to catch it somewhere out here. You want to always be right here. So you throw it, even if the ball goes a little out of the way, you try to move your feet quickly to get over to it. So you stay here, and then you throw it off a little bit and try to make sure that you're still in an athletic position when you catch it, in a springy position.
Okay, that's good.
Then you can just change it up a little bit, and instead of catching it with the same hand, you catch it with the opposite hand. So where before we would have thrown it like this, now when you throw, you touch it with the opposite. You catch it with the opposite hand. So that's one way that you can do it. Another way that you can do it is like that. So you're tapping with the same hand that you throw it with, and you're catching it on the other side. Then you can do the same thing with the knee. Now the throwing hand touches the opposite knee, and the catching hand touches the opposite shoulder before the catch, and you keep trying to alternate, okay? So don't rush. Make sure you're figuring it out, and as you go, you'll be able to pick up the pace a little bit. Next, you're gonna throw it off the wall. Touch the ground first with the catching hand. Then to make the timing a little trickier, instead of throwing it straight off the wall, you're gonna bounce it off the floor, off the wall, and then catch it, okay? Same thing, you throw, touch the ground with your opposite hand and catch with your opposite hand. The last one, the coordination is fairly simple, but it's more of an athletic positioning drill and making sure that you can adjust on both sides, right and left. So you're gonna throw off the wall. You try to get the ball to come back on the same side of the body that you threw it. Catch it, but use the catch, downswing of that arm to pivot to the other side, okay? So you're not throwing it, catching it, and then turning to reset up. You're trying to do it in rhythm to make it more efficient and save time. So you throw it, you use the catch to pivot, and then you're already wound up, throw. Okay, so those are just a few variations, try them out. There are infinite variations, within variations. A lot of times we get questions like, is this good for X sport? It's good for any sport that involves hand-eye coordination, okay? Doing these drills, if you're a cricket bowler or a tennis player, it's not necessarily, these aren't sport-specific drills in the sense that they're gonna directly improve your bowling efficiency, but generally they will improve your efficiency in any ball sport, anything that involves hand-eye coordination, because you're improving the way that your arms, legs, torso, and eyes communicate and work together. So that's the point of it. You're just engineering yourself to respond better in those situations, hence the term athletic engineering. So this is just one component of it. Hand-eye coordination, like I said, there are a million different drills and games and situations that you can create depending on the area you want to work. Give these a try and let us know in the comments what you think. Thanks for watching.